Hello friends, according to your request, today in this session we are going to learn about domain name server, DNS. So let's start. In this first session, in this video one, we are going to learn about what is DNS. DNS basically used in Windows for IP to name and name to IP. This is a key component of Active Directory domain. In Active Directory domain, DNS is the mandatory feature of Windows Server. So let's take a look how we can install DNS server role on a server. To install it, go to the server manager. Once the server manager is ready, go to the manage option, click on the add role and feature option, click on next, select the server you want to install, and there you can get a DNS server. So once you select the DNS server, it will automatically include the DNS server tool feature inside it. So if you do not want to include it, you can remove it from here, or if you want to include it, you can include from here. Click on the add feature option, then click on the next option. Once it is done, click on next again. So one more thing, before you do any type of DNS installation, DNS server role, you always make sure you have a static IP configured on your machine. So let me check that whether we have any static IP or not. As of now, I think we have a static IP installed in this machine. Let me put 100 and specify a name of 172.0.10. One more thing I need to do, and that is on the DNS we should have 172.0.0.1. Okay, so we should have 172.0.0.1 mentioned, because this is the local machine, and then click on the it will take some time to get it installed. Once it is installed, we'll again back to this video. Installation has been completed on this machine, so click on the close option, go to tools, under tools you can get a DNS option. Click on the DNS. It will give you the DNS configuration wizard. And this is the host name we have in this machine. And DNS. There is no forward and reverse lookup zone has been created as of now. By default, we are going to work with forward and reverse zone. Okay, forward zone is basically used to configure IP address of a means creating a record. It will help us convert name to IP address. And reverse lookup is basically used to create PTRs, which is also known as reverse lookup. This is basically help Active Directory domain networks to look up name from the IP address. Forward lookup is the forwarding process, and reverse lookup is the reverse process. One is used for name to IP conversion, and another is used for IP to name conversion. So before we start, we have to create a zone first. Let's create a zone. Create on the new zone. Click on the new zone. Once you click on the next, we have three options. The first one is primary zone. This is the basic default setting of a DNS. and by default it is used for primary zone. Okay, and it is a create a copy of a zone that will update directly on this server. This is the mother server of the DNS. Okay, and secondary zone basically used when the mother server is somewhere else and you want to create another server as a member DNS server. So in that, case, you have to click on the secondary DNS zone and proceed with the setting. And sub zone is a totally different thing. You can create a sub zone of only creating name server, certificate authority, name of authority, possibly a host record, configuring zone, not authorized. Basically type of zone. In this video, we are going to cover about the primary zone here. After selecting the primary zone, click on the next option. Now we have to put a domain name. Here we have mcslab.com. So let's click on the next option. So as you can see, it will create a file name here, and it is already have the put the name as our domain FQ name is cslab.com.dns. So if you have an existing file, that means you have taken a backup, you can put the file on this particular location, system root system 32 under DNS, and you can select the existing file using this option. Now click on the next option, and it will now give you some information about whether you are configuring both dynamic source, dynamic update, or you will not allow the dynamic update. So dynamic update will help DNS to update DNS record automatically once any machine try to register themselves on the DNS. So this is less secure, but most probably if you are using a domain-based network, where machines are joining, disjoining day by day. So in that case, this is very important. And in that case, in our video, we are going to select, allow both secure dynamic updates as well. Click on the next option. Now it will give you a summary of the zone and click on finish. Once it is done, as you can see, the primary zone has been created, and it will, by default, it will create these two address. One is ASOA and another is NS, which is the name server. This server is known as name server because this is the primary server of the DNS. The secondary thing is reverse zone. So if you can click on the reverse zone, you can see here also we have three zones, primary, secondary, and sub zone. Again, we are go with the primary zone, and whether it will ask you for it is a IPv4 or IPv6 reverse, we are going to configure it IPv4 reverse zone. Now we have to do, we have to put the network IP address only. Okay, this is the network part we have selected. Click on the next. It will automatically add in hyphen ADDR address dot ARPA, ARP, that means ARP, a record for .dns. Again, we are selecting the both dynamic updates and click on next and finish. Reverse zone has been created, forward zone has been created. Now, if you can click on the DNS server, and here you can get two another option. One is root hints and another is forwarders. Some of my followers have some queries about root hints and forwarders. What is root hints? If you can click on the root hints, these are the root hints by default installed while you are installing DNS services. So this is basically the root server which is used to look up about, as you can see here, root hints resolve the query zones do exist on the local DNS server. They are only used, forwarders are not configured or failed to respond. So this is the basically root hints which will be in role, in position, once the forwarder fails. Okay, forwarder are no longer configured or forwarder is not available on the server, then it will ask root server for additional record. These are the root server, which is by default installed with the Microsoft DNS. Okay, you can add another root server, you can edit any root server, or you can remove it from here. So now go to the forwarders. This is very important, guys. Forwarders basically use, suppose you want one of your domain clients want to look up google.com. Okay, so google.com is not basically part of your local LAN. So in that case, how it will get resolved? In that case, it will need the access of global DNS, like 8.8.8.8, as you can know, 4.4.2.2, or 8.8.4.4.2. So these are the global servers, public servers, which is available, as well as once you purchase a ILL line, that means internet list line, they will also provide you the local public DNS address for public DNS lookup. So if you have such address, always go to the edit option and you can put the IP address or FQDN. In here we can put 8.8.8. As this is a local environment, it will not validate. It will not validate. But if this is an internet facing machine, that means if the machine has internet connection on it, then it will automatically get resolved the name of the 8.8.8.8 machine, and it will validate automatically. After validating it, as this is a test environment, that's why it is not going to be valid, but it is a public DNS address, as you know. If you are sure about that and your domain server have the ability to look up publicly on this particular DNS, just click on the, once you click on the OK, it will be added as a forward. This will only work once your local DNS server unable to provide the DNS result query update to the clients. Okay, so this is the basic forwarder, which is used, forwarding option, which is used in domain to look up external domain, external domain. So click on apply and OK. So guys, as you can see in this video, we have created we have configured the Windows Server domain name service role on a server, standalone Windows Server 2012 server. We have created a forward zone, we have created as well as a reverse zone, and we have also checked what is routines and forwarders. Thank you. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, please don't forget to subscribe.